the majestic cityscape of Sydney, Australia. While the iconic Opera House and Harbour Bridge garner most of the attention of photographers and postcards, the city is home to some of the best examples of both modern and postmodern high-rise architecture in the world. The Sydney Tower, also referred to as the Centre Point Tower, is Sydney's tallest structure and the second tallest in all of Australia at a height of 1,014 feet. Construction began in 1973 and was completed in 1981 at a cost of $36 million. The Governor Phillip Tower stands at 745 feet and was completed in 1993 at a cost of $300 million. Clad in over 13,000 panels of gray and pink granite, and contains 64 floors that begin 10 stories above street level. One block south is the award-winning Aurora Place, completed in 2001 at a cost of $500 million, and was designed by the Italian architect Renzo Piano. The main roof stands at 509 feet, with its spire extending to 718 feet and containing 41 floors. Built in 1992 at a cost of over $1 billion, Chifley Tower stands at 709 feet, with its spire reaching 801 feet. It houses 53 floors and contains a 400-ton steel pendulum near the roof to counteract the sway of the building in the wind. Deutsche Bank Place, with its iconic goalpost spires, was completed in 2005 at a cost of $450 million and contains 39 floors. Stands at a height of 525 feet, with its spires reaching 787 feet, and contains an atrium that stretches all the way to the top of the building. Part of the World Square complex, the World Tower is officially Sydney's tallest building, not including spires or antennas, at a height of 755 feet. It was completed in 2004, contained 73 floors, and at its completion was the Southern Hemisphere's tallest residential building. Sharing the World Square complex with the World Tower is the Ernst & Young Tower, also known as Latitude. It reaches a height of 623 feet, with its spire extending to 728 feet, and was completed in 2004. Located near the World Square complex, the Marathon Tower was completed in 2006. It was designed by celebrated Sydney architect Harry Seidler and contains 48 floors, with its distinctive sail-like spire reaching a height of 558 feet. Located in Midtown Sydney, near Town Hall Station, the City Group Centre stands at 676 feet, with its spire reaching 797 feet. The building contains 50 floors and was completed in 2000. The postmodern Art Deco glass tower that is the HSBC Centre is located on the corner of George and Bathurst Streets at the southern end of the CBD. It stands at 531 feet, contains 37 floors, and was completed in 1998. The octagonal MLC Centre stands at 748 feet and contains 60 floors and is home to the Sydney Consulate of the United States. The building was designed by Harry Seidler and was completed in 1977, and at the time was the tallest building outside of North America, as well as the tallest building in Sydney from 1977 to 1992. Built in 1989, Gateway Plaza towers 538 feet above Circular Quay. The building contains 46 floors and was built at a cost of $165 million. Angel Place opened in 2000 at a cost of $190 million. It reaches a height of exactly 500 feet and contains 35 floors. Designed by Harry Seidler, Castlereagh Center is known for its tubular exterior frame and slim mid-block location. It stands at 600 feet and contains 34 floors. Westpac Place opened in August 2006 at a cost of $87.5 million. The building contains 40 floors and stands at a height of 545 feet. The circular tower at Australia Square opened in 1962 and for 9 years was Australia's tallest building. Also designed by Harry Seidler, the building stands at 558 feet, contains 50 floors, and houses an observation deck and revolving restaurant. Suncorp Place was originally designed for Qantas and was completed in 1982. It contains 42 floors and stands at a height of 633 feet. 1 O'Connell Street was opened in 1991 and retains the sandstone facades of the site's former buildings as part of its base. It stands at 545 feet tall and contains 34 floors.